I want to welcome everybody to the Spring Ames Community College Police Academy 2022 graduation ceremony. I'm Jeff Smith, I'm the director of the Police Academy. And if you'd all stand while the Greeley Police Honor Guard post colors, and then we will say the Pledge of Allegiance. Pledge allegiance to the flag, United States of America, and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Order, on. Ready, face. Forward, march.
All right, thank you, Greeley Police Honor Guard. So I really appreciate everybody showing up today. If you look around the room, you can all have a seat, sorry. There's really not a lot of script to this, so I just have a bunch of notes. So this academy would not be possible without a lot of people in the room and a lot of involvement from around the college and the community. So I want to start off by thanking our agency sponsoring classes of Windsor Police, Fort Morgan Police, Brush Police, and Federal Heights Police Department. So thank you all for your sponsorship of the Academy. I also want to thank the agency affiliated instructors, and this is a big list. So we're not done, so if you don't hear your agency, we have an open application online. So Greeley Police, Weld County Sheriff's Office, Loveland Police, Broomfield, Greeley Municipal Court, Greeley DA's Office, Larimer County, Longmont, State of Colorado, Aurora, Evans, Adams County, Brighton, Johnstown, Lock Buoy, and the U.S. Treasury. Those all encompass our instructors currently. The benefit of that is that we give our students, our cadets, a lot of exposure to a lot of different agencies, a lot of philosophies, and that's just something that we want to keep growing. So I also want to thank our advisory committee members. The agencies represented on that are Greeley Police, Louisville Police, Loveland Police, Fort Lupton Police, Weld County Sheriff's Office, Windsor Police, and Lock Buoy Police Departments. Advisory is something that when we want to do something different in the academy, obviously post is over the entire academy, but the advisory committees at a community college are heavily involved, and all of our career and technical education programs, they're controlled by the advisory committees, and those all make up community representatives, people that are actually in the industry. So we have a lot of industry involvement, a lot of agency involvement. I also would like to thank all the local chiefs, commanders, supervisors, officers, and all current and former military and law enforcement. So if you are one of those, would you mind just standing so we can give you a round of applause? It's something else that we also tried to implement this year, and I actually don't see her in the room, but we hired a new trainer. She just finished her master's degree from University of Pittsburgh in sports and exercise science, and this academy class will tell you that while she may have tried to kill them during PT, they would never have been upset with her because she just cares so much about our cadets. So Reg Stump, are you here yet? She was planning on being here. So go ahead and stand up so that we can all... She is short, but she is standing now, so. Regina's been a tremendous asset to the college and to the academy, and the cadets will tell you that she is difficult to work with, but also fabulous about getting them motivated. We also had a lot of academic improvement. So Clay Fuller, who's gonna be speaking a little bit, Clay is our full-time faculty. Clay is responsible for keeping the class going, keeping the students motivated, updating lesson plans, PowerPoints, all sorts of stuff. So Clay, would you mind standing so we can thank you? All right, also, because we are a certified police academy in the state of Colorado, we are overseen by the Colorado Post Board, which is Peace Officer Standards and Training. I do not see anybody in the room from Post, but they were gonna be here today. So I would like to thank them. I also would like to thank Flat Rock, which is part of Adams County Sheriff's Office. Flat Rock Regional Training Facility is literally located on the north side of DIA. So if you ever drive out there, you can see your planes landing while you're on the driving track. It's a fantastic facility. If there's one word to describe Flat Rock, I would say intense. It is outstanding training, so I want to thank both the Post Board and Flat Rock for their involvement with our academy. And then the Ames folks that I would like to identify, Randy Souther, Director of the Public Safety Institute. Mary Gabriel, Executive Director of the Windsor Campus. And then our Board of Trustees and Cabinet members that came today. All right, and most importantly, the thing that actually keeps our academy running is our program coordinator, who was responsible for today's events, including the fire and police academy graduation ceremonies, Mike Dowd. All right, so with that, it is with distinct pleasure that I bring up Commander Aaron Lopez. Aaron is the commander over the Windsor Police Department, has recently been selected to go to the FBI's National Academy. If you know anything about law enforcement, there's two or three schools that are the most, the biggest things that you can have on your resume. FBI National Academy is the top school. Others include Southern Police Institute's Homicide School, and there's a collection of others, but being an FBI National Academy selectee and then graduate is a tremendous honor. So, Commander Lopez.
Where's the best positioning for this thing?
Perfect.
Perfect. Thanks, sir. Appreciate it.
Yeah. Good afternoon, everybody. Thank you very much for being here. Family, friends, guests, instructors, faculty, agency representatives, and supporters. It takes all you guys to help support these fine candidates here. Thanks for being here with us. Again, I'm Aaron Lopez with the Windsor Police Department. I'm our administrative commander. We're here today to honor, recognize the effort and achievement of the Police Academy cadets who've dedicated themselves to community service through public safety, including the communities of Federal Heights, Fort Morgan, Brush, and Windsor. Law enforcement officers hold a special place in each community they serve. Being a police officer is more than a job, it's a calling. And those called upon to serve are unique individuals, able and driven to do things that many others are not. To face challenges that might cause many others to crumble, police officers are some of the rare individuals trained, equipped, and willing to run towards a grave threat rather than away from it, to potentially put themselves in harm's way to save the life of a stranger. Service as a police officer is honorable and noble, but officers do, do what they do, not because it's popular, but because it's the right thing to do. We are fortunate in our communities to enjoy not only strong community support, but to have our collective ranks composed of incredible men and women of the highest character and honor, including the cadets we see before us today. To fully describe all that entails this unique form of service is difficult. But broadcaster Paul Harvey was able to encapsulate some of the challenges faced by police officers in a narrative that he wrote in 1970. I'd like to share that with you today. Please keep in mind the time in which this was written and understand that today the term policeman includes honorable men and women in blue. Again, this is Policeman by Paul Harvey. A policeman is a composite of what all men are, a mingling of saint and sinner, dust and deity. Gold statistics wave the fan over stinkers, underscore instances of dishonesty and brutality because they are news. What that really means is that they are exceptional. They are unusual. They are not commonplace. Buried under the froth is fact. And the fact is that less than 0.5% of policemen misfit the uniform. And that is a better average than you'll find amongst clergymen. What is a policeman? He of all men is at once the most needed and most wanted. A strangely nameless creature who is sir to his face and pig or worse behind his back. He must be such a diplomat that he can settle differences between individuals so that each one will think he has won. But if a policeman is neat, he is conceited. If he is careless, he's a bum. If he's pleasant, he's a flirt. If he's not, he's a grouch. He must make instant decisions, which would require months for a lawyer, but if he hurries, he's careless. If he's deliberate, he's lazy. He must be the first to an accident, infallible with a diagnosis. He must be able to start breathing, stop bleeding, tie splints, and above all, be sure the victim goes home without a limp or expect to be sued. The police officer must know every gun, draw on the run, and hit where it doesn't hurt. He must be able to whip men twice his size and half his age without damaging his uniform and without being brutal. If you hit him, he's a coward. If he hits you, he's a bully. The policeman must know everything and not tell. He must know where all of the sin is and not partake. The policeman, from a single human hair, must be able to describe the crime, the weapon, the criminal, and be able to tell you where the criminal is hiding. But if he catches the criminal, he's lucky. If he doesn't, he's a dunce. If he gets promoted, he's got political pull. If he doesn't, he's a dullard. The policeman must chase bum leads to a dead end, stake out 10 nights to tag one witness who saw it happen but refuses to remember. He runs files and writes reports until his eyes ache, but to build a case against some felon who will get dealed out by a shameless Seamus or an honorable who isn't honorable. The policeman must be a minister, a social worker, a diplomat, and a tough guy, and a gentleman. And of course, he'll have to be a genius because he will have to feed a family on a policeman's salary. Police officers today are comparatively paid better today than they were when Paul Harvey made these comments. But none of us entered this profession to get rich. We do, what we do may not always be easy or popular, but we did not enter this profession to please everyone. We did it to make a difference, a positive difference. And what Paul Harvey was really saying in this narrative is that police officers are special, that what they do is challenging and noble, and recognize that they do what many others cannot. We need good people in our profession now as much as ever, and seeing these candidates achieving this milestone today gives me great hope for our communities and our profession, because I know that inside every patrol car and behind every badge is a skilled, thoughtful, caring, and driven human being, committed to serving their communities honorably and with a level of professionalism and dedication that few others possess. To the families, friends, and supporters of these fine cadets, thank you. Thank you for the past and future sacrifices you have made and will make to support your loved ones who wear the badge. This includes your support of them during their odd hours away and for your attention in hearing the challenges and successes they experience, even in times when it may be hard to relate. The unconditional love, understanding, and support you provide are what help to allow law enforcement officers to serve and thrive. Behind every great officer is a great support system. To the graduates, I sincerely congratulate you on your achievement today, for your choice to serve, and for your dedicated pursuit of the noble profession you're about to enter. The path you have chosen will sometimes be a challenging one, but I can confidently say from my own observations that it is also one of the most rewarding you'll ever experience. You're now part of a tight-knit brother and sisterhood dedicated to making our communities safer and better places. Congratulations and stay safe out there.
All right, now I'd like to bring up Clay Fuller to have an overview of the academy.
A lot of high tech for me. So for your family and friends, they know how much you've been gone, how hard you've been working. Most colleges and universities, 12 credit hours means you're a full-time student. 15 hours in a semester, credit hours, means you're hard charger. You're doing extra work. This semester, these students have completed more than 30 credit hours. In other words, they've carried a double load. And they've had very little sympathy from us. We don't take it easy on them. We didn't cut their homework. We made them do everything, sometimes again. You earned your place here. You guys worked hard. And it's been a great class. They were studying before class, after class, and it showed in their grades, it showed in their post-exam. They did extremely well. All our classes have been good. This class has been exceptional. You volunteered to do what others don't want to do. You volunteered to go where others fear to tread. I and every other instructor here really respects you. We admire you. You make us feel good that other people are going to carry on the hard work that all the law enforcement officers here, past and present, are doing now and have done. We are glad to have you. Thank you.
All right, now as we move forward in some of the fun stuff. So challenge coins, there's a long, rich history with the challenge coins, and to be honest with you, I can't do justice what we just had. This is our celebration week for the college, and on Monday night we had the veterans coining ceremony, and we got a beautiful explanation from Trustee Oxinger and the veterans, but the challenge coin that we give out in the police academy is very specifically designed for the police cadets. So if you guys want to line up in alphabetical order, which I know the post exam is over, but you still have to know some of that stuff. So we're going to do a gift from Clay, and then a coining, and then we'll bring them back up to do the final awards, and then their certificates, and then you guys should be done. And then we've got food and drink. So, all right. You want to do the knives? No, the knives. Sorry. Yeah. Okay, so Jack Clifford, please come forward.
Appreciate it. Thank you.
Good job.
Appreciate it. Yeah, thanks.
Rebecca Cummings. Yes. Alexander Mai. Samantha Munson. Vivian Pebley. Congratulations. Robert Trotter. And Skylar Willis. Congratulations.
Do you want any of the other instructors to have a greeting line?
What's that?
Yeah, let's go bring them out.
Yeah. All right, if you are one of our instructors, would you mind coming up on stage with us? We're going to do a big line. Because you guys are the reason that the students are so successful. So they would much rather shake your hand than mine. Trust me, they're tired of hearing from me. All right, so this is their certificate of completion. This also includes multiple certificates from Flat Rock. This includes their SFST, which is DUI roadsides. It includes their TCC certificate, which is tactical casualty care. So If they're ever around a shooting victim, and honestly, not if, when, we've trained them to apply tourniquets to be able to save lives. So super intense training that they go through while they're here. So, all right, Jack Clifford. I'll try to get out of the way.
Sarandoni, appreciate everything. Thank you, Jeff. Appreciate it.
All right, Rebecca Cummings. Alexander Meyer.
Yes.
Yes.
Thank you very much. Thank you, sir. Sorry. Thank you so much. Thank you, sir.
All right. Samantha Munson. Vivian Pebley. Robert Trotter. Skylar Willis.
Congratulations.
All right, you guys can have a seat. We have one more presentation to do. You guys can have a seat too. Thank you. All right, one thing that I did want to add during the coining ceremony. So as we go into next week is actually National Fallen Officers Week, nationally. I said that twice. So you're gonna see a lot of blue lights out there on houses. You're gonna see a lot of blue flags out there on houses. It's a big deal because unfortunately in today's society, we have statistically about 30% of the people that go into law enforcement leave law enforcement within 3 to 4 years and don't come back. So it's not like they jump to another agency, and that's in the nation. So these seven folks are going into an incredibly difficult, difficult time in their lives and difficult profession. We had 9 officers lose their life this last year in Colorado. And I just want to take a minute to identify them and give them our respect. Eric Talley, Boulder Police Department. Deputy James Herrera, Denver County Sheriff's Office. Deputy Daniel Trujillo, Denver County Sheriff's Office. Gordon Beasley, Arvada Police Department. Eric Schur, Aurora Police Department. Ty Powell, Windsor Police Department. Clay Livingston, Elbert County Sheriff's Office. Joseph Pollock, Douglas County Sheriff's Office. And Wayne Wire, Mesa County Sheriff's Office. These people gave the ultimate sacrifice. Please remember that when you see the officers on the street, or you hear other people deciding to say poor things about the job that cops have to do, because this job is difficult. It is probably, next to active military, the most violent job that you can go into, and the most thankless. And so by the community understanding more of what these officers go through, then it helps support everybody. These are the people that are out there to come to your house in the middle of the night when you hear a floor or a weird noise or your dog start to bark. These are the ones that get up and respond to you when you don't want to search your own area. These are the ones that are trying to pull bad people off the road. So it is a very thankless job. Remember that this next week. It's only 1 week of the year that we have National Fallen Officers Week, and it's important that we support our law enforcement. So, all right, so we do have some awards to give out. The students have been quickly wondering what all is happening with this. So there are three awards that we give out from Flat Rock. Those are the skills training. So we have top arrest control, top driver, and top firearms, top gun. And then we have overall academic achievement, and then the director's award. So arrest control, they learn pressure point control tactics. It is not fun. If you are a spouse, loved one, significant other, child of one of these cadets, I will apologize to you because I'm the one that asked them to go home and practice. Who they chose for that is up to them, but I actually did say, you know, practice so that you can learn this stuff. Plus, last week they got a chance to go for 3 minutes with me, and every single one of them, I think my wife's in the back, I had a busted eardrum, a busted lip, I had bruises up and down my body. They had a lot of fun, I'll just say that. So, and it was in a controlled environment, so Clay was, he was supposed to call time, and he just kept letting it go. So I'm not sure what that's about, but someone else did his evaluation this year, so maybe that's what it's about. So anyway, arrest control tactics. These seven have been trained very, very well. They've learned how to fight at a level that is not normal, but unfortunately is absolutely necessary for the job that they're going to do on the street. So I would like to bring up, let you do, Alexander.
Thank you, sir.
All right, firearms. Firearms awards are difficult, and I went through the same academy in 1993. I'm still bitter about losing out the Top Gun award by a guy that shot a Ruger. And if you know anything about semi-automatic guns, Ruger back in 1993 wasn't known for the greatest. This guy was amazing. Just shows that anybody can be super efficient. So I actually was in line for this award and lost it. I know it sounds silly, but Skylar Willis, would you please come forward?
Congratulations.
And I'm quite confident that he is not going to be driving this way, going to the donut shop or 7-Eleven. But the skills that they get in driving is ridiculous. They have a skills track, then they're doing high-speed lane changes at 80 miles an hour. They're doing stuff backwards, sideways a couple times. Not exactly supposed to do it that way, but their driving ability is ridiculous. And Flat Rock does a fantastic job. We break cars every academy, and they never really balk at us, which is a very much appreciated, trust me, especially since my chief business officer's in the room. So, Alex, come on up. Academics, this academy is very difficult. Post requires 556 hours. Most of that is in academics. We actually run, in this academy, about 620 hours. So in 16 weeks, you do the math, that's a little bit more than a 40-hour week work job. And then they have to go home and study. They're studying for the post exam. Every single one of these students passed the post exam by a high number. So post has a minimum passing, and each one of these students blew it out of the water. It was fantastic. So we couldn't be prouder. Out of the entire academy in 16 weeks, roughly 15 weeks, there's 1,500 points that come up to the grand total. There were two people in number one and number two, and the points separating number one and number two were 2 points. 2 points out of 1,500 possible. Outstanding. I've never seen an academy, and Clay's been running the academy longer than I have. We've never seen this close of competition for the Academic Achievement Award. But Skylar, would you mind coming forward? Now, these students all make quite a big impact on us because we're here a lot. Clay's here more than anybody else. And I've got a couple of our previous students in the room. They can tell you they get to know the instructors very well. And we all look out for them as they go on to their agencies and stay in contact with them. So it's a lot of fun seeing the instructors show up, seeing the previous students show up. But the instructors all get a chance to speak up, and especially the lead instructors, they get a chance to speak up and vote on this next award. These are for the students that have such great attitude, such personal drive. They're just fantastic all the way around. We want to make an award for them. So this is the Director's Award, and it's with great honor that I ask Jack Clifford to come up front.
For everything. Appreciate it.
Absolutely. All right, so that concludes our ceremony. I want to thank everyone for showing up. There is cake and drinks on the side. Also for the cadets, we've got the Alumni Foundation with a gift for you over on the table. So you guys are welcome to hang out as long as you want. My boss won't kick us out of here, so there's too many cops in the room. So feel free to enjoy yourself, take photos, and have fun. Thank you all for joining.